Hey guys, it's Abby. If you're new, welcome. And if you're not new, welcome back. Today's video is going to be pretty low-key. It's raining and gray outside, so I thought I would just do a good old-fashioned what's in my bag video. The next video after this is going to be my lipstick collection. I've had quite a few people ask me to do that again, so that is what I will do. Okay, so let's just get into the video. Okay, so the bag that I'm currently using is a Rough and Tumble. If you guys saw the handbag role play, which if you haven't, I'll either put it here or here. I'm not sure which direction it is, but the link will be up in the corner. I showed a couple of my Rough and Tumble bags. Now, if you want a full handbag collection video, please leave it down in the comments. I'd be happy to do it for you and tell you a little bit more about the brand and so on. But that was just a few of them. So this is one that I just received in a trade. This is a small 1904. In soft black, and it's a vintage one. And the reason I know that is because of how the pockets are laid out differently than my Mineral Earth one that I have. Cool thing about these bags is that they can be worn as a shoulder bag, as a crossbody bag, or as a backpack. And I love that about these. This one in particular, the leather is just so squishy. I mean, it's so soft. So, this one is shade the contents, and then once the bag is empty, I'll show you the pocket layout. So, in the very back pocket, which is this here, I have my CBD plus Delta 8 thing. It has a wedding cake cart in it. Perfectly legal. So I have really severe anxiety. And this helps a lot. So the way that it works is you double click. And he preheats the cart. Takes about 10 seconds. Then you press the button. And then it's just cake smelling water vapor. So it helps my anxiety. I've had this since last November. And I've only used a little bit. It's very effective. So, I carry that around. Next is... it's a little fidget dude. Got this out of a vending machine. And you can just, like, take his body apart. And he just kind of feels fun. So that's that. It's a little black bear. And that's that in this pocket. This one also has a little, like, ID window thing there. So that's that. That's all I carry in that pocket. Okay. Continuing into the rest of the bag. A good old receipt. And this bag is cool because it has like a cinch thing, which I don't ever have cinched, but what is this receipt even to? Oh, this was me shipping out a bag to somebody. So that's that. Alright, I'm just gonna reach in and take things at random. Okay. The first thing that I grab is another Rough and Tumble item. This is a Rough and Tumble EDC wallet. They have a small EDC, a medium, and then a large. This is the wallet. The small is a little bit taller and has D-rings that you can attach a strap to. But I just wanted the wallet. Took advantage of a sale that they had recently. And this is in Distressed Espresso. Absolutely beautiful leather. Okay, and inside we have a middle compartment where I keep all my cards, ID window, and then I use the other sides for like my first aid kit. Okay, this is Rough and Tumble. So I have like little mini Q-tips, I have burn cream, I have gauze, I have band-aids, aspirin, butterfly closures, and, you know, like I said, I use the middle for my wallet. And, this is big enough. You could, I think, easily fit an iPhone in it. And I like this because it has a wristlet strap. So that if you just want to take this and go to the store, you can. And it's just so soft and squishy. And I think it's going to age beautifully. So that's that. Next is my planner. Now, I'm a big planner person. And this is a Cheek Sparrow cover. I forgot what it's called. But it's like a brown purple. It's beautiful. And inside I have my Hobonichi Weeks in it. This pocket has my vaccine card, receipts, etc. And the back just has the back cover of the Weeks. And like I said, it's my planner. So this is the Hobonichi Techo Weeks Mega. And the Mega has like tons of extra paper in the back. So you can take notes or lists or whatever. So always have this in my bags. I really love this cover too. I got this off of the Cheek Sparrow BST page. That's that. Next is another Rough and Tumble. No, I'm sorry. This is a Balenciaga item. I have one Balenciaga bag, and I got it from Fashion File. It's a Balenciaga city bag, which I can show you quickly. I guess it's Balenciaga city. And this goes along that same thread, except it's in blue. It's just one of their little wallets. And inside here, I have an extra scrunchie. I have some lip products. I have a lip gloss or liquid lipstick from the brand Queen in the shade Monroe. Super beautiful. And like I said, I'll do a lipstick collection video after this. And then I have an Anastasia Beverly Hills lip gloss in the shade Vintage. That's one of the minis. Okay. Then I have an Urban Decay lipstick in Blackmail, which is a super dark color. have a little eyeliner and a eyelash glue, which funnily enough I've used more for repairing hangnails than anything. Sorry about my baby crying. I have an extra set of keys to my house. And then in the bottom is just change. In the front pocket is a key to my old house and some more change. I think those might be the old keys to my house. Because we changed the locks quite, you know, when we moved, so. I don't know, I gotta ask my husband. Anyway, that's that. Next is another rough and tumble item. Like I said, I took advantage of a sale. These were a lot cheaper than they normally are. So this is a, I believe, what they call a slipcase. And this is in aubergine, which I have a bag in this color. And in this, I have more lip products. So I won't show you all of them since I'm going to do a video, but I have Clinique Black Cherry. I have Burt's Bees Tinted Lip Oil. I have a spray-on perfume in O2 from Garden Party by Memoir. Beautiful little spray-on. I have Sexy Mother Pucker by Soap and Glory. I have Lemonade Lip Gloss by Dose of Colors. I have a Travelo that has body spray in it. I have ChapStick Total Hydration. Urban Decay's lipstick Comfort Matte in 1993, which I will show you. It's one of my favorites. I have a NYX Simply Red Lip Cream in Knockout. And lastly, a Vintage by Jessica Leap Skin Lip Gloss in Pink Sequin. So that just holds the products and, you know, little things that would be floating around my bag otherwise. Next is another rough and tumble clip case. I forgot what leather this one is in. I'll have to look back at my order. This just holds a bunch of like random crap. I have some Abreva cold sore cream. I have a lip balm. A friction pen. I have a lighter for candles. I have another friction pen. I have tampons. A Couture by Juicy Couture rollerball. A pen refill. And lastly, a Paneer Descends hand cream in Clementine. That smells so nice. It's a gorgeous hand cream. So, and I think I got that from like Cracker Barrel a few years ago. But it still smells great, and it wasn't that expensive either. I think it was like $8. And you need so little when you do use it, so I think worth the money then. All right, continuing on, we have a Chuck E. Cheese wristband that is my 4-year-old's. I keep it with me so that she doesn't lose it. I have some mail. I have another lipstick that really should be in the bag. This is a Maybelline Superstay Ink Crayon in... What shade are you? Drive the Future. Can you see? It's like a beautiful brick color. They smell like cake, and they have a sharpener on the end. I just threw into the abyss. Okay, and then I have, like I said, a pen. I have some hand sanitizer. This is by Hello Bello. And the kid loves it. It sprays on, dries super fast, and she can do it herself. Okay. Next, I have good old face mask. This one is from Old Navy, and it's really pretty print. I have a bubblegum dum dum for, you guessed it, my daughter. I have a drawing that my daughter made me. I have a priority mail sticker because I was going to mail something, then ended up not needing the box. I have a pack of gum. I buy these big packs. And then I have my keys at the bottom, which I'm not going to take out because they're loud. I have more pens. This is a Sharpie gel pen. And this is a Papermate InkJoy gel. Great pens. I have my daughter's little play ring. I have a little notebook that says Idea on it. This came from a Jibuntecho planner. I have some chapstick, and I have a little pea fidget dude. These are really cute. Look at how happy they are. It's just cute, and I like to pop them out. Sorry. Just fun. And that is it. Except for my keys, like I said. So inside here you can see there's the little leather pocket where that notebook was. And then there's an ID pocket. And more stuff in there. And then there are a zip pocket, and then it says Rough and Tumble, made in Maine. And that is my bag. So I'm gonna put this stuff in while I'm talking to you guys. So I am really glad it seems like y'all are enjoying my videos. I haven't really seen any negative feedback on them, so that's good. So it seems like the general consensus for the true crime videos is that you guys don't care if there are pictures, you just want the story. So I can do that. So I'm going to put a poll on my community page with a selection of a few cases, okay? And I should probably take the lip products out of there since I'm gonna film that next. So like I said, I'm gonna put on my community page a poll. And the poll is going to be a couple of cases, and y'all please vote on which case you want me to do first, okay? I have a couple ideas, and I can do that, okay? So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. My next video, like I said, will be my lipstick collection video, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Bye.